This is Top 30. Coming up, a huge data breach has exposed nearly 800 million people. Ridiculously cold temperatures are breaking records in the Northeast, and we take a look at the most shocking snubs from this year's Oscar nominations. Welcome to the show. I'm Amanda Salas, filling in for Kristen Smith, and here are 30 things you need to know right now. Volvo is recalling 200,000 diesel cars worldwide because the fuel line could crack, causing fuel to leak into the engine compartment. The recall includes the Volvo V40, S60, and V60, including the cross-country version, as well as the 2015 to 2016 V70 and XC70, S80, XC60, and XC90. And the NFL is set to discuss whether or not to make pass interference calls reviewable. The topic has been discussed for years in the league, but was brought to light again following what many are calling a blatant case of pass interference that officials didn't call in Sunday's Rams-Saints game, which resulted in the Rams heading to the Super Bowl. Deliberation of pass interference reviews will take place in the offseason. And speaking of the Super Bowl, some people look forward to the commercials more than the actual game, and they don't come cheap. A new report says CBS is selling 30-second spots for more than $5 million. But what they're not selling? Marijuana. CBS rejected a 60-second ad making a case for medical marijuana. A CBS spokesperson says the network does not accept cannabis-related advertising under its broadcasting standards. CBS, not CBD. Now let's go to the New York Stock Exchange for our Fox Business Minute with Jerry Willis. Jerry, there's a new app that lets you pray with the Pope?
Pope Francis asking his flock to pray with him online. Click to Pray is the Catholic Church's first ever smartphone app. The app will let the world's billion-plus Catholics know what the pontiff is praying for and, quote, accompany the Pope in a mission of compassion. Starbucks could be delivering in your city soon. The coffee chain aims to expand its delivery service to a quarter of its U.S. stores. The company said that it will launch the services to some stores in cities like New York, Boston, L.A., and Chicago in coming weeks. Starbucks tested the idea in 200 Miami shops last fall. And anyone looking to go to the Super Bowl should be ready to cough up some serious dough. Ticket vendors have set an average listing price of nearly $8,000 for the game in Atlanta. Now, if it holds through game day on February 3rd, that price would rank as the highest on record for the secondary market.
So what's the cheapest ticket you can get right now?
The cheapest ticket for the game at the moment, a paltry $2,800.
Well, good to know. Thanks, Jerry. Time now for the New York Minute with Rosanna Scotto from Fox 5 New York. So, Rosanna, I hear it was a bit chilly in New York this weekend.
Oh, let me tell you something. You know New York can be a cold place, but now this was literally. Monday was the coldest January 21st since 1985. The high was just 14 degrees with the wind chill making it feel as low as negative 20. Do you know how cold it was? How cold was it?
How cold was it?
Thank you. The Bryant Park fountain froze over. The people who went on the subway were greeted by icicles hanging from the pipes above the car exits. The sub-zero wind chills and 45 mile per hour gusts also led LaGuardia, JFK, and Newark to delay a total of 587 flights. City officials were warning everybody to cover up, limit time outside. The Department of Homeless Services even issued a code blue asking New Yorkers to call 311 if they saw someone in need of shelter. Oh. And while rain is on the way, Amanda, temperatures are expected to rise the rest of the week. Oh, we're going to be so spoiled. We're going to hit the low 50s by Thursday.
Oh, okay. I'm shivering just thinking about what you just said, Rosanna. And on the topic of winter weather, I hear that winter is coming to the Met in the form of a scavenger hunt.
I know what you're saying, Game of Thrones. Yes. Okay, so this is going to be so much fun. Starting March 1st, the tour guide company Fable and Lark is bringing Game of Thrones and Lord of the Rings to life at the Met. So Crown and Profit will be an epic fantasy adventure that sends people who go to the museum all around the Met to find shining armor, medieval art, sculptures, tapestries, and coats of arms that may have inspired the iconic stories. Now, I did something like this about a year ago, only it was with a dance troupe, and we exercised through the Met, and I have to say I had the best time walking like an Egyptian past the mummies.
Yes!
So fun. I recommend this.
Okay, Rosanna, now this story I can get down with. The only Snow I'm interested in is Jon Snow.
Oh, I'm with you on that one in a New York Minute.
Yes, Rosanna, thank you. Okay, so bright and early Tuesday morning, Kumail Nanjiani and Tracee Ellis Ross were on hand to reveal the nominations for the 91st Academy Awards. Leading with 10 nods apiece were The Favorite and Roma, which will each be competing for director, actress, screenplay, and best picture, where they'll go up against Black Panther, Black Klansman, Bohemian Rhapsody, Green Book, A Star is Born, and Vice. With more on Tuesday's nominations, the major first, shocking snubs, and what to expect from this year's hostless show, we're joined by our friend Headcrack over at Dish Nation.
That's right, Amanda, the Oscar nominations are out. Well, as expected, Lady Gaga is nominated for Best Actress for A Star is Born, and she'll be facing Glenn Close, who's up for a 7th Oscar for the movie The Wife. Now, Glenn has never won an Oscar, so this one looks like it's going to be a close call between these two. Now, I'm very excited that Black Panther made history as the first superhero movie to ever be nominated for Best Picture, and it only took the Marvel Cinematic Universe 18 movies to accomplish that. And can you say a snub is born? The most shocking snub was Bradley Cooper, who didn't make the cut for Best Director, but don't feel too sorry for Bradley. He's still in the running for 3 Oscars, including Best Actor, Best Adapted Screenplay, and of course, Best Picture. Also snubbed was Denzel Washington's son, John David Washington, and Emily Blunt, who didn't get in for either Mary Poppins or A Quiet Place. But it wasn't at all quiet for Emma Stone, Christian Bale, Mahershala Ali, Amy Adams, or Melissa McCarthy. They all got nominations for acting. But probably even more exciting day for some of the first-time nominees like Regina King, Adam Driver, and Rami Malek. And oh, get this, Spike Lee got his first ever nomination for Best Director. Remember, the Oscars will take place on Sunday, February 24th, and I hear they still don't have a host. What do you say, Amanda? Should we go in? I think we got this.
Yes, Headcrack, put it out into the universe. There's still time, and we're good on our feet. All I have to do is call. Thanks again, Headcrack. They say print is dying. Big name bookstores like Borders have gone out of business, and people are spending more time in front of a screen. But it turns out book sales are actually up, and independent bookstores in particular are thriving. According to the news site Quartz, the number of independent bookstores boomed between 2009 and 2015, going up by 35%. Print book sales rose in 2017 by 2% and continued to climb into 2018. Michelle Obama's inspirational memoir, Becoming, was the best-selling hardcover book of 2018. And it has remained the number one best-selling book on Amazon since its launch last November, giving it the longest streak in the top spot since 2012's 50 Shades of Grey. So in this digital age where we're glued to our smartphones, Vox.com suggests it's because of all the time we spend online that people are actually yearning to hold a physical book. But even a good book on a Sunday afternoon can't pull everyone away from social media. The hashtag Bookstagram features more than 27 million photos of people showing off their latest read. Danielle Knox from Fox 35 Orlando has what you need to know today. So Danielle, I'm not surprised by this. Stay-at-home parents are pretty valuable.
Well, stay-at-home parents do it all, as we all know, right? And while they don't earn a tangible paycheck, if they did, survey says it should be more than $162,000 a year. According to salary.com, stay-at-home moms and dads have the jobs of educators, housekeepers, nurses, event planners, and accountants, just to name a few. And their work week is longer too, 96 hours. The survey hopes to bring attention to the fact that being a stay-at-home parent is one of the most difficult jobs a person can have. Well, it turns out being bitten by the love bug isn't just an expression. Scientists have found falling in love actually does cause women to produce a specific kind of protein. New romantic love has a psychological as well as physiological change. Scientists took blood from 47 young, newly in love women and found their bodies were producing something called interferon, which is a protein typically deployed to fight viruses. But alas, when the love starts to die, so do the interferon levels. Well, put down the sponge, because it turns out stacking up the rack instead of sudsing in the sink is the best way for the environment to stay on track and also to make your dishes cleaner, too. According to the EPA, a kitchen faucet can take up to 27 gallons of water to wash an entire load, while some dishwashers use as little as 3 gallons to get the job done. The water-efficient machines also sanitize your dirty dishes more than you can do manually. I didn't need a study to know the dishwasher is the jam, especially when you've got kids, right? Back to you.
Right. Such a time saver and good for the environment, too. Thanks, Danielle. Still ahead, we have an update on the Duchess of Sussex, and we'll tell you why it's time to change your passwords. Don't go anywhere. Top 30 will be back after these messages from our sponsors.
Why let itchy, irritated skin keep you from all the fun this winter? Cortisone 10 works fast to help soothe irritation and relieve itch for 10 full hours. Cortisone 10.
Welcome back. Time now for Royal Watch with our royal commentator, Victoria Arbiter. Hi, Victoria.
Lovely to be with you, Amanda.
Cheers. So what's Meghan Markle's latest do-gooder act of kindness?
Well, last week, the Duchess of Sussex paid a visit to animal welfare charity Mayhew, one of her newly announced patronages. And while she was there, she met with staff and volunteers, but she was also able to interact with all the animals looking for their forever homes. Now, there was one dog in particular by the name of Minnie that caught Meghan's eye, and I'm glad to say that after her royal photo op, Minnie was adopted the very next day.
Oh, I'm so glad Minnie was rescued. Too cute. And I also hear that we have an idea now what Meghan likes to eat for breakfast.
Yes, we do. Well, over the weekend, Meghan's long-term makeup artist, Daniel Martin, posted to Instagram suggesting he had enjoyed tea at Kensington Palace with the Duchess. He thanked her for being the consummate hostess, and he referred to her as the avocado toast whisperer. Turns out Meghan laid on quite a spread with black tea, Sandringham truffles, and avocado toast all served on silver plates.
True California girl, because all I got from that was avocado toast whisperer. I love it. I'm only eating avocado toast off silver plates from now on. Mm-hmm. Prince Philip, he was in a car accident last week. Do we know what happened?
Yes, Norfolk police are moving on with their investigation into exactly how Philip's Land Rover collided with a Kia that was carrying two women and a nine-month-old baby. Now, one of those ladies sustained a broken wrist in the crash. The other, the driver, she and Prince Philip escaped with minor cuts. I'm very relieved to say that the baby was unharmed.
So glad to hear everyone is okay. Victoria, thanks so much for the royal news, and we'll see you next week. Okay, let's go to the New York Post, where Heather Hausworth has today's front page news. Heather, this is a story about crime and cookies.
Thanks, Amanda. This is one bad crookie. A cold-hearted crook snatched up more than $1,000 from a Girl Scout troop at a shopping mall in New Jersey. The thief posed with a walker and appeared to be handicapped. Security camera footage shows him swiping an envelope filled with cash and checks off of the table. The heartbroken youngsters, ages 5 to 12, were left crying and are now unable to afford a long-awaited trip to Savannah, Georgia, where the founder of the Girl Scouts once lived.
Do authorities have any leads?
Unfortunately, the police still don't have any suspects. As for the troop, they are back to raising money for their trip down south. Their spirits may be down, but they are marching on.
Well, we wish those scouts the best. Thanks, Heather. We have some great advice that we're going to start and end this story with, and that's change your password. An article by Consumer Reports says more than 772 million consumer accounts had email addresses and passwords posted on a hacking website called Mega. After a series of security breaches, the collection of sensitive information, which has since been taken down, left countless financial and social media accounts open to hackers. In phishing schemes, hackers are posing as different companies to get your information. Emails may come from who you think is your bank, social media platform, or even media provider like Netflix. The phishing emails may ask you to click on a link or download an attachment as a way to get access to your information. Boston University has great tips to stay safe online. First, do not click the link. Hover over the link with your mouse. A pop-up will appear at the bottom of your browser to see where the link will really take you. Report and delete the email if you've called the organization and they've said they never tried to contact you. It asks for your password. It is regarding an account or order you don't know about, or it has multiple grammatical errors. And finally, change your password frequently. Okay, let's face it, we aren't getting any younger, but we may be able to look it. Today's Top 30 Steal is a pure daily care new derma wand, and you get a special 87% discount. The new derma skin wand amplifies cell turnover by supercharging ATP synthesis to slow, halt, and ultimately reverse the aging process, leading to firmer and younger looking skin. This is a portable, handheld, high-frequency skin therapy machine. It's extremely effective in reducing wrinkles and fine lines by boosting circulation and collagen production. The Pure Daily Care Nuderma Wand retails for $300, but today you can buy it for just $39. That's an 87% discount. You can get this right now at morningsave.com while they last. And Top 30 will be right back. Welcome back. In a report by U.S. News and World Report, homeownership rates are making a slow climb after hitting a 50-year low in 2016. About 20% of the decline in homeownership among young adults is attributed to their increased student loan debt. In fact, here's a number to make you cringe. There is a total of $1.5 trillion in student loan debt to be repaid, according to the Federal Reserve. About 20% of the decline in homeownership among young adults is attributed to their increased student loan debt. According to Forbes, more than 44 million borrowers have an average of more than $37,000 to repay. Because of that, about 400,000 young adults would have owned a home in 2014 alone had it not been for student debt. The Fed also says that high education debt early in life can mean low credit scores later in life for many borrowers, making it even harder to own a home. We may also continue to see a drop in new homeowners unless policymakers revisit repayment or tuition rates. So it may still be quite some time before you see a lot of millennials as your neighbors. He's the drummer for one of the most famous bands in the world, but Rick Allen from Def Leppard is on tour showing off a different skill. Mike Jarek from Fox 29 in Philadelphia joins us with more. Hi, Mike.
You got that right. He is iconic. I mean, he is a legendary drummer with one of the biggest bands from back in the late 70s and 80s, Def Leppard, like you said. So Rick also has another amazing talent. He's an artist. So we invited him onto our show, Good Day Philadelphia, and he showed off.
I love to paint. It keeps me off the street corners. Well, my mind anyway. I started painting with my youngest daughter, and I was really inspired again, so I got back into it.
Well, as you can tell, the things that influence his art, of course, his music. You know, he's been drumming since he was 9 years old. Also, of course, his upbringing in England. The blue and white painting there, those are actually bottle caps from English beer. And of course, he is also influenced by the accident that happened in 1984, a traffic accident that took his arm.
Wow, he's such an icon, and it's great to see him exploring different types of art. Thanks, Mike. And we're just about at that time of year when people give up on their New Year's resolutions, which can leave them feeling a little blue. So Paige Failing from Fox 46 Charlotte joins us now with tips to brighten up your outlook. Hey, Paige.
Yeah, Amanda, you know, there's a reason they call it Blue Monday a couple weeks into the new year, right? And you just said it, feeling like a failure can really bum anybody out. Well, one new book, 10 to Zen by psychotherapist Owen O'Kane says, just 10 minutes a day can help you turn things around. So first, he says to just stop and check. Put yourself on pause to really focus on your mind for a few minutes. Then use one of several suggested tactics like tapping to clear your mind. After that, relax and fill all that cleared space with air by deep breathing. Finish up by gradually coming back into your conscious thoughts, then recharge and set forth on your mission, envisioning yourself in a protective cloak that will guard you from anything negative, pulling you from your path for the rest of your day. There, Amanda, don't you feel better already?
You know I do, and that's great advice for all of us. Thanks, Paige. More Top 30 coming right up. Welcome back to Top 30. Be honest, whose Netflix password are you using? A new report by insurance company Country Financial suggests 74% of Americans share their digital accounts with family, friends, or even exes. Entertainment streaming services like Netflix and Hulu reigned with 47% of respondents sharing. Mobile plans and shopping accounts like Amazon Prime followed with 42 and 41% each. Burdened by record student loan debt, millennials were also prone to sharing services like Uber or Lyft. One service the survey was unable to capture was music streaming, as Spotify, Apple Music, and others actively worked to make sharing difficult. But while three-quarters of respondents share their online accounts, far fewer share the financial responsibility, just 36% actually contributing to the bill. That is, the average American spends $237 on these services per month. Given that price tag, financial experts suggest these costs are an easy place to start when cutting back. I guess many took that to mean using someone else's. And that's it for today's show. Thanks for watching, and here's what's coming up on the next Top 30. There's a surprising reason why Americans are drinking less alcohol. Plus, new research finds hit songs are getting shorter, and couples who laugh together stay together as long as they don't do this one thing. You can also listen to the day's biggest stories on the Top 30 podcast. It's all coming up on the next Top 30.